Assalamu alaikum and a very good morning to all my wonderful students. Welcome back to Subject English Class 7. Now students, I hope that you are clear about the previous chapter which we have completed, especially tenses, words, punctuations. Now, tenses are very important to understand other chapters too. While explaining voice also, I told you that referred tenses. Now once again, before start this chapter, I would like to say that refer all the videos of chapter 4 tenses. Because to understand this chapter number 9, direct indirect speech, tenses is very important. You will easily understand that if your direct sentence is in particular tense, so how you have to convert in indirect speech. Now students, we'll start today this chapter number 9, direct indirect speech. Now you have learned in the previous class also that direct sentence means what? Direct sentence means that the person's actual words means what the person has spoken. What is the actual word of that particular person? And what is indirect sentence? What is indirect speech? Here, we have only the meaning of what that particular person has said. Direct speech means actual words of that person. We haven't repeated anything. Direct sentence, we say the actual word of that particular person. And indirect means that we are just saying the meaning of what that particular person has said. Now look at here. Srikant met Rohit for the first time near a construction site. They were both on a walk. There was a lot of noise and they couldn't hear each other clearly. They had to scream in order to be heard. Here is their conversation. So here, Srikant and Rohit conversation is given. Now because of the noise of construction, construction means the building is under construction. So here some noise came and that's why they are screaming to each other to talk. So here a short conversation is given. So look at everyone at page number 18. Srikant said, "Good morning. Are you new here?" Rohit said, "No, I am a lawyer." Now look at what's the question of Srikant and what's the answer of Rohit. So you can understand that they both are not listening each other proper. But look at the conversation. Srikant said, "Good morning. Are you new here?" Rohit said, "No, I am a lawyer." "Oh, I thought you are a lawyer," said Srikant. Rohit said, "No, I am new here." So students, here this short conversation is given. We'll convert it in reported speech. Now indirect speech, you can say reported speech also. We can convert it into reported speech, but not now. After understanding this chapter, we'll once again back to this exercise. Now, first of all, we try to understand it. We'll see more example related things. We can understand that if your direct sentence is in particular, suppose that in simple present, so how we have to convert it. Look at students at page number 80. Here one example given to you. Read the two sentences given below. Read the two sentences given below. Ginny said, "I'm tired." Now look at this first sentence. Is the actual word of Ginny. What she said? Ginny said, "I am tired." Now, in reported speech, Ginny said that she was tired. Here, we are just giving the meaning. But look at here. This sentence, I am tired. And Ginny said that she was tired. So here, you have to understand that if your actual sentence is your direct sentences in simple present, so you have to convert in simple past tense. I is for Ginny. Now here we are just giving the meaning what Ginny said. So after said, you have to put that as a reported verb. As a reported word, we have to use that. Ginny is a girl. So in place of I, because I is used for Ginny. So here, Ginny is a girl. So that's why here we have to put she. If here any boy name is given, so we have to write here he. Am convert into was, because we have to convert everything in simple past tense. And tired is tired only. Ginny said that she was tired. Now look at students at page number 81. Here, the explanation of the first sentence is given to you. That in the first sentence, we have repeated Ginny's actual words. This is called direct speech. So students, when you are saying the actual word of that particular person, it's known as direct speech. Note the inverted commas that we have already learned while learning punctuation. That when there is a person's actual words given, so we have to put it in the double inverted commas. In the second sentence, we have not repeated Ginny's words. We have only given the meaning of what he or she said. So clear students, when you are just giving the meaning of that particular person, what he or she want to say. So it's known as reported speech, or you can say it's known as indirect speech. So direct speech means when there is the actual word of the person. And indirect or reported speech means you are just giving the meaning what that person had said. You may have noticed the following changes in the reported statement. Now, what we have seen in a previous example, which kind of changes we have seen? Look at here. The reported words are introduced by that. Ginny said that. You know, by converting into reported speech, or you can say indirect speech, we use the word that. That's why it's known as we are converting into reported speech, and that time we are using this that as a joining word, so it's known as reported words. The reported words are introduced by that. The that can be omitted. If you want to skip it, you can. The inverted commas are removed. When you are writing the actual word, that time you have to put inverted commas. But when you are saying just the meaning of that person, what the person is saying, so that time we have to remove the inverted commas. The verb am has become was. So am turned into was. The pronoun I has become he or she. According to person. If you are thinking that Ginny is the name of boy, so it's convert into he. It's change into he. But if you are thinking that is the name of girl, so you can turn into she. I turn into he or she. Here are detailed notes on the changes that should be made when we turn direct speech into reported speech. So, in your book, very nicely given how we have to change direct sentence into reported sentence or indirect speech. When the reporting verb, that is the verb said in the example above, is in the past tense, the tenses of the verb in direct speech usually change as follows. So, we have to see the reporting verb. If our reporting verb is in past tense, So according to these, we have to change reportate speech. So in first sentence, Ginny said, so it's already in a simple past. So if it's in a past tense, so that time we have to change all the things in direct speech while turning into indirect speech. Now look at here, the first example. The simple present changes to the simple past. Means here, if your reporting verb is said, that time you have to do all the changes. But if our reporting verb is only say or says, so that time we will not do any change. But here already reporting verb is said. That's why according to the tense, we have to change the reported speech. Look at here, direct sentence. He said, Anne looks sad. Now look at here, he said. Said is known as reporting verb. Now here, reporting verb is simple past tense. That's why we have to change according to this tense. Anne looks sad. Now looks is a verb. It's showing that this sentence is in a which tense? Yes, this sentence is in a simple present tense. Now, according to reporting verb, is a past tense, so that's why we have to turn into past. But here, this is showing that your sentence is in simple present. So that's why we have to change our reported speech in a simple past tense. He said that. That if you want to skip, that fine. He already skipped. He said Anne. Now look at here. Anne is a name of person. So that's why here no need to change anything. Here in place of Anne, if any pronoun given, then only we have to change according to this person. But Anne is already name of person. So in place of Anne, we have to put Anne only. Anne looked sad. Looks past form is looked. Looked sad. I hope students are clear to you. Your reporting verb is said in simple past tense. That's why we have to change the tenses of this reported speech. Here, simple present tense are sentences. That's why we have to convert it in simple past tense. Now look at another example. The present continuous changes to the past continuous. Here, simple present changes into simple past. So here, present continuous changes into past continuous. Now, as we know that in present continuous, what will come? Am is are plus verb plus ing. So in past continuous, what will come? Was or were plus verb plus ing. Same. Only in place of am is are, we have to put was and were in simple past tense. Look at the direct speech. He said, I'm writing to my uncle. Now, who said here? He. What's the exact word of he? I am writing to my uncle. That's why it's in inverted commas. Now, he said that. I am writing is showing present continuous tense. So, by turning into past continuous, what we have to write? Was a verb writing. Now, what's our subject here? Who's the speaker here? He. So, I am writing. He was writing. According to this speaker, we have to take was or were. He was writing to my uncle. My uncle means here, his uncle. So he, my will convert into his. Suppose that here she, girl is there. So what will come here? She was writing to her uncle. Look at another. If suppose here you is written, you said, we said, they said. So according to this, here all changes will come. That we understand that if its sentence is in present continuous, so we have turned into past continuous. But after we have to look at these changes too. If there is name given, so according to name, if it's a boy name, girl name, according to this we have to change. But in place of names, if there is given pronoun, so according to pronoun we have to change here also. Now look at another example. The present perfect changes to the past perfect. So all the present change into past. But if it's in present, only simple present, so turn into simple past. Present continuous, so turn into past continuous. Present perfect, so it will turn into past perfect. Now, what is the format of present perfect? In present perfect, we have to put has or have. And with this, we have to use past participle form of the verb, means verb 3. And what's the format of past perfect? Only had will come, whatever. Our subject is whatever is there. We have to put had plus past participle form of the verb, means verb 3 only. Now look at here. Direct sentence, she said, I have finished the work. It's a short form of have. I finished the work. I finished is showing that our sentence is in simple present. Sorry, present perfect. So by turning into reported speech, what we have to write here? She said that, or you can omit that. She said, I finished. Here, who is I? She, yes? So we have to put she in place of I. She. Now, have finished. Have finished turned into past perfect. So what will come? Had finished. Had finished the work. Now look at students. Here you have to just remember that if our sentence is in simple present, turn into simple past, present continuous, turn into past continuous, present perfect, turn into past perfect. You know, as we have learned in voice, while learning voice, we have seen that our tenses will not change. But here, we have to change tense, present to past. Now, your present is in simple present, so turn into simple past. Present continuous, then turn into past continuous. And present perfect, then turn into past perfect. Now, students, still you have a need of related this tense. First of all, you have to understand this tense. And if you have still any doubts related this tense, so you can go through the fourth number chapter tense. There, I already taught you in a detailed way. So first of all, open those videos, try to understand all the videos, then come back to this video. You can easily understand. I'm sure that you can easily understand this chapter very well. Now students, in a next video we'll see how to turn if it's already given in a past tense. So what we have to do, if it's given in a simple present, so we are turning into past. Present continuous, we are turning in past continuous. Present perfect, we are turning into past perfect. But if it's already given in a past tense only, so what we have to do, that we will learn in our next video. Thank you all and have a great day.